blessed as we share in the story of Christ's birth. This choir's put in a lot of hard work since September. We don't claim to be professionals, but the thing I love about this choir is they're singing out of their heart. And we all want to praise the Lord and hope that you feel that glory as you share and hear and watch the video that we have. You are going to help us celebrate with the first song this morning. And the words will be on the screen. And so I'm going to have you, in a few minutes, I'm going to have you stand, and I will direct you and help you know what to do as our choir comes forth. So you're a part of the celebration. You're a part of the choir this morning. So we're grateful that you're here. And as the bulletin says, on a quiet, calm night in Bethlehem, heaven's light broke through the darkness with the birth of Christ. And shepherds and wise men, they joined a host of angels to rejoice in this divine arrival that happened on earth. But 2,000 years later, we can reflect on that one single event in a humble stable that changed the rest of history and changed our lives. So we pray that you'll be blessed through that this morning.
Thank you. us, Christmas is a season of joy and glory. But for Mary and Joseph, the journey began with a surprise, danger, and uncertainty. It took them from the town of Nazareth to Bethlehem, to the darkness of a stable and the wonder of a miraculous birth. On the hills nearby, shepherds fell in terrified awe at the angelic announcement that a Savior had been born for them. And so began their late-night journey to find him.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joy for all the nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With the angelic host proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem.
Jesus has been retold for over 2,000 years. We picture the poor carpenter Joseph and his virgin bride, the inn that had no room, the baby sleeping in a feeding trough. And though we're certain that the Father had planned every moment, we look with wonder and say, how strange that God's only begotten Son would come the way he did.
Sure, he must have been surprised at where this road had taken him. 'Cause never in a million lives would he have dreamed of Bethlehem. But standing at the manger, he saw with his own eyes the message from the angel come to life. And Joseph said, why me? I'm just a simple man of faith. Why him with all the rules in the world? Why inside this stable filled with hay? Why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. Think of how it could have been if Jesus had come as he deserved. There would have been no Bethlehem, no lowly shepherds at his birth. But Joseph knew the reason love had to reach so far. And as he held our Savior in his arms, he must have thought, why me? I'm just a simple man of faith. Why him with all the wonders in the world? Angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, this is such a strange way, such a strange way. Oh, this is such a strange way to save the world.
Rushed into Bethlehem that night, what did they expect to find? Could they have imagined the Prince of Heaven in such a place? Still, they knew enough to fall in worship at the sight of the baby who was Christ the Lord.
This is Christ the King, whose shepherds are.
Every nativity scene has the familiar figures: Mary, Joseph, shepherds and kings, camels and cows and sheep, and of course the baby lying in the manger. As we put each one in place, we're struck again at the thought, it's the greatest story in the world, and it's all true.
Sin and buried shame.
carols ring out today with the good news of his coming. Let's join with the angels in singing with great joy for all people. The Savior has been born in Bethlehem. He is the Messiah, our Lord.
Presented the message of Christmas, and we know that Jesus Christ was sent.